mining processes in general, how to join two parts together. There are two ways. Number one, temporary join or temporary joining. Number two, permanent join or permanent joining process. Temporary join means that if you have two bars A and B, and you want to join them both together. This is A, this is B, and you want to join them together through temporary joint. Then what shall you do? Having a hole here, then use bolt and nut. This one is called temporary joint. Why it is temporary joint? Because when you dismantle the joint, when the joint is dismantled, then the two bars will not be hardened, will not be hardened. This is the definition of a temporary joint. Temporary joint, if you want to open the joint or remove the joint, then you can get A and B without any harm, the same as before, without any harm. Two bars A and B are sound without any damage. This one example, we have too much examples. Another example, the key found between the shaft and the gear or body. We use key. Another example, between two sheets. Then we can assemble them by what is this? Rivets. Three examples for temporary joint: bolt and nut, bolt and nut, key, and rivets. These are temporary joints. On the other side, there is permanent joint. And permanent joint representing welding. This is welding. This is welding. You can join the two blades or two sheets or the two bars, but on the opposite of that, what does it mean? If the joint is dismantled, if the joint is dismantled or disassembled, what will happen to the two bars? Comma, the two bars will be hardened. The two bars will be hardened. You cannot use them again. Here I can use the two bars again, but here no, I cannot use the two bars again because opening the joint will hurt them. This is what they do. Therefore, from here and down, we are talking about welding. Welding for permanent joints can be done in both states of the matter. The matter has two main states, either solid state or liquid state. Solid state, and you can do the process on solid state of the material without fusion, without melting. And the other bar on the in the liquid state, in the liquid state of the material of the two sheets. Liquid state, solid state. Liquid state is called fusion welding. Liquid state is called fusion welding. If I starting from here, what is it? Welding. That one is called fusion welding. Fusion welding. Fusion welding. Now let's give examples about solid state. Examples and brief description as general knowledge. We have five types. For example, number one, forging welding. We do welding by forging. Heat the two pieces, make certain joint like this, one bar like this, another bar like that, then drop hammer here. They will diffuse and give you junction. Hot, okay? Hot forging. Number two, friction welding. Friction welding. And friction welding is a recent technology. Friction welding is a recent technology. It has many types. Friction welding is a recent technology. It has many types and depends on. Now for example, if you have two axes and you want to weld them, you want to weld two axes together, then fix one and rotate the other one at high speed, 2,000 revolution per minute, for example, and let them to touch the two surfaces during rotation. Then heat will be generated, friction, high friction and high temperature. Then after that, press them on. They will give you a good joint and is used to form the axe, the wheel axis of a truck. It is recent technology, as I said. If it is done on very small, very fine bars, we can use number three, ultrasonic. Number three, ultrasonic. It is a friction ultrasonic welding. It is a friction welding, and depends on the concept of friction, But very suitable for what? For very fine bars. Hair wire, for example. Hair wire, yani. Very, very fine wires to a plate or something like this. Ultrasonic welding. Number four, soldering. And you know soldering? All of you know soldering? You know what? Welding of soldering. Welding of wire with the iron, arakun al hik, then this shape. And that's button, it is electrical. Okay. Then you push this button, it will be heated, and then you will turn the wire and lead or silver, tin, and then doing the soldering. Welding wires. Number five, brazing. Number five, brazing. Brazing has very wide industrial application. Brazing, okay? These processes of welding do the job without melting the blades or the sheets. صورت في احد يصور ولا خلاص صورته؟ ما في؟ اول واحد مين؟ درج تايب الكتريكال انرجي. Now we're talking about what? About the energy used in fusion welding. Energy used in fusion welding. Energy, first one. Electrical energy. Number two, chemical energy. Chemical energy. Number three, beam energy. Beam energy. Or, there is the physics of beam. Electrical, such as arc welding and resistance welding. Arc welding and resistance welding. Arc welding and resistance welding. Chemical energy. Make benefit of the chemical energy in welding. We have two types, two main types. Oxyfuel welding, thermite welding. For the last one, lower beam physics, we have two, lower electron beam welding, electron beam welding, laser welding. Now, for time factor or time considerations, we concentrate on our welding. And if there is time and we have time enough, we'll touch the resistance welding and oxyfuel. If there is time. هذه هي إخوة in general the flow chart of a classification of welding processes, and still we have here some classification for our welding. I will take it alone, this one, and concentrate it here. Arc welding has two types: either open arc or close the arc. Or hidden. Or hidden arc. Or hidden arc. or not depends on the electrode. Depends on the electrode. Electrode is the part to convey the current to welding process, and it is also the part to be melted and added to the pool. This is, in brief, the definition of electrode. This electrode, we call it electrode, conveying current and to be melted and fill the pool, the welding pool. Is it okay? Fine. It depends on the electrode. If it is consumable or non-consumable. Consumable electrode or non-consumable electrode. طبعا ال E هنا تعني ايه؟ ال E هنا تعني electrode. And that E means energy. Depends on the energy. Energy for what? Depends on the energy. Depends on what? Yes, used for what? Used to, to melt the metal. Yeah. Because we said that fusion welding doing what? Melting the metal in liquid state. We do welding in liquid state. صح ولا لا؟ ممكن واحد هنا واحد واحد ممكن متاح ها كلير واضح الكلام يعني here start from here the two blades what are in liquid state to melt the two blades we need energy صح we need energy this energy can be obtained either from electrical means or electrical power or from chemical reactions such as oxyacetylene. Oxyfuel means oxyacetylene because we can use acetylene or we can use the butane gas, the natural gas instead. Okay? And the beam nature or beam physics, electron beam welding. Again, electron beam welding and laser welding. Laser welding. Okay, about that. Number one, the nature of the arc. Is it open? You can see. Or it is hidden, you cannot see. We have certain type of welding. The arc you cannot see. It's hidden. That one depends on the electrode. Is the electrode consumable or non-consumable? Non-consumable, for example, tungsten arc welding. Tungsten inert gas. Inert gas. The symbol is TIG. Tungsten inert gas. Tungsten inert gas. Or you can say plasma welding. Here the consumable electrode. The next classification about how to protect the pool, the arc itself. The arc should be protected against the air, oxygen of the air. Otherwise, oxygen can enter the arc and make oxidation for the metal, lower corrosion. Therefore, how to protect the arc? Arc protection. Arc protection. Either using gas or using flux. Flux is a chemical material, a compound of our combination of chemical material. This flux can be added in the shape of coat, in the shape of the coat, outside the electrode like this, outside the electrode like this, we coat in here, chemicals of the flux. This is the coat, flux coated electrode. Or can be stuff inside the electrode is called cooling. What's the meaning of that? It means instead of coating the electrode from outside, we do the electrode as a tube like this, having certain thickness. Then we stuff flux inside. And this is the electrode. If I do a section here, if I do section here for this electrode and magnify, you will see it like this. The electrode is a tube having what from inside? Flux. This is the magnification and section here. This is the tube wire, and being stuffed, huh? With flux, based flux, not powder, just based. That one is called flux core. And it has very long, and round is one around the ring, by this way. And all of it stuff with flux. So the number one coated, number two cooled, number three powder. Number three flux can be in the shape of powder. Okay, three. Coat, cool, powder. This process, this is the electrode coated from outside. This is called manual metal arc welding. And all of you know this process. Manual metal arc welding. Manual metal arc welding. This is the abbreviation or the electrostar standard. Okay, there's another one. Shielded metal arc welding is the same. If you say shielded metal arc welding, it is the same. But this one is easier because you say manual, giving indication about the manual process. Okay? Manual metal arc welding. Manual. اكتبها ولا تعرفوا تكتبوها. Manual metal arc welding. Or you can say shielded metal arc welding. Manual. Double N. Metal arc welding. Or you can say shielded, it is the same process. It's the واحد American expression, American expression or English expression. واحد أمريكي واحد إنجليزي. Shielded metal arc welding. بس الأسهل والأحسن من manual metal. لما تقول manual خلاص عرفنا مش تقصد. إن shielded metal ما يعرفها إلا واحد خبير في الولدنج. يبقى عارف يعني إيه shielded metal arc welding اللي هي المانيوال. Okay. That one is called flux core arc welding. Flux core arc welding. ما فيها كلمة صعبة صح؟ FCAW flux core arc welding. Flux core arc welding. The powder, the process using powder flux is that one. Because the powder flux accumulated on the arc and make it hidden. You cannot see. Arc is on in the process, but I don't see. Okay? It's called submerged arc welding. That one is the same. That one, okay? This one is that one. It's called submerging the process, huh? submerging or cooling. The abbreviation, lower rungs in the standard, SAW. Submerged or cooling. Here, this one. Submerged or cooling. What's the meaning of submerged? You can say hidden. Mahmur, huh? Mahmur or hidden. This other word giving the same meaning of hidden. This about the flux. How to add the flux in the process. واضح الكلام؟ Is it clear? Good. Gas. We have three types of gas. Inert, active, and oxidizing. Three types of gases here. Inert, inert gas, active gas, and oxidizing gas. Oxidizing gas. Now we said that we should protect the arc against the oxygen of air. Now, no, here this one, we mean to add oxygen for what? To oxidize some harmful elements found in the pool. And for example, if you are welding high carbon steel and you want to reduce the carbon content in the joint, you should use oxidizing gas. Oxidizing gas such as CO2 or pure oxygen. Okay? Inert gas with consumable electrode, like, what's the name of the process? Metal inert gas. Metal inert gas. Metal inert gas. Metal inert gas. انت اكتبها ما عندي حيز اكتب عليها. Metal inert gas بالكامل. عندنا ميك. What's the name of ميك? Metal inert gas. And we have what? Tick. What is tick? Tungsten inert gas. But tungsten is not permitted to melt. Tungsten electrode is what? Is not consumed. That one is consumed and be added in the joint. Keep a ميك. Metal inert gas, MAG, metal active gas, MOG, metal oxidizing gas. MIG, MAG, MOG. About the gas, eh? Different gases give you either MIG or MAG or MOG. Welding, كل the welding. ترى, we have about 150 types of welding processes in the world are used, and every process has its own field of application. Here you can say light also. Sunlight is used in welding. For example, in a spaceship, the astronaut fada, if they want to make welding, they have a mirror and collecting the rays of the sun and making very concentrated focus of this light, melting the metal, making the joint finished. And so on. Many types of welding processes. Okay, now let us talk about fundamentals of welding. Up to here we finished the classification of welding processes, mainly. Not in details, but in main manner. Okay. Now we have two bars, A and B. And want to make them one piece or a welding joint here. This is A, this is B. I want to make somewhere here a joint between them. And this joint will be energized by the forces between atoms. Therefore, melting will diffuse both elements together to the range of atoms. Therefore, I will have a pool here. I will have pool here. This is the pool. And filling this space by filler rod. See structure. See chemical structure. Chemical composition and metallic structure. See here chemical composition and metallic structure A. Chemical composition and metallic structure B. Mixing them all together in this pool, and then when finished, after finishing the joint, it will be like this. These are the sheets, and here is the joint. Now the joint is filled with weld metal. This one, after finishing, and after removing, it's called slag. We have some slag here. That layer is called slag. And the other one is called weld metal. Weld metal. Here A, here B, and here what? D. Chemical composition and metallic structure D. This D is a combination of what? A, B, and C. This is the phenomena or the mechanism of making a fusion with D. If you look in this direction, if you have a section here, if you got a section here, and look this direction, you see what's found here. Now let us say that this side, this view, has the sides of the blades or roots. On this direction, I will see the length. Fine. Welding is done in a line. And this line here, normal to the board. This direction. I want to see from this direction, I will see the length of the blade. This is the length of the blade. Weld metal has been added up to here. And this is the weld metal. It will take certain depth of the blade, forming the weld metal and leaving another depth. Then the pool will be here. Welding is here. This is the wire, which is called electrode. Then the arc. The arc is here. After that, we'll get protection shield, protection gas shield here, protection gas shield here. If I have that one, is gas shielding, gas shielding. What's the meaning of shielding? Cover, you can say cover or protection. Shielding means cover or protection. Huh? Gas or gaseous, can say gaseous, gaseous shield or gas shield. The red one is what? Is the arc, while the black one is the pool. Now this one is weld metal, and this part is what? This part is الاوريجينال شيت صح؟ It's called Parent method.
Parent
method. Parent method means the basic sheet without welding. Now, all this process here is going from right to left or from left to right?
From right to left.
From right to left, there is a welding speed. We have here welding speed, welding speed. Welding speed, for example, V or something like this. Units, meter per minute. Okay? Meter per minute. This found on page 657. The energy given to the bowl, what will happen here? What will do the energy? The energy will be distributed in this area, in this zone. Not on that zone, also not here. Biologic energy will be concentrated here. This is the Parent method or the base method. You can say base method, you can say Parent method. Both are correct. Energy will be distributed by this way here. Here. The center of the arc is here. Where do you expect most temperature? The highest temperature? At the center. At the center, you will get the highest temperature like this. And then lower to the right and lower to the left. And very similar. Will be similarly like this until it reaches room temperature here. Very similar to that one. Almost like this. Now, say this is the temperature of the arc. Temperature of the arc in the middle, at the middle, reaches about 2,000 or 3,000. Let us say 2,500 for steel, for example. Steel melts at 1,000. 700 or something like this, or 600. Let us say up to here. Up to here, 1,600, which is the melting point of steel. Therefore, what do you expect in this zone? What do you expect in this zone? I expect molten metal. Molten metal. The pool will extend from here to here. But lower than this will never be melted. Lower than this melting point, this is the melting point. Lower, either right or left, there will not be any melting particles out of atoms. Okay. But certain important temperature is also found, which is the crystallization temperature. The crystallization temperature almost half of that one, and 750. Say 750 up to here. 750 for steel is the crystallization temperature. Therefore, I expect the crystallization happen to that zone and to that zone. from right and left.
Of what?
Of the fusion zone.
Where is the fusion zone?
This is the fusion zone. This one is the fusion zone.
I will see it like this. I will draw it. In red color, would be like this.
Extends inside the sheet to certain depth. By this way. This is the border of fusion zone. And that one will be another layer. Sorry. إذا العمق أكبر من اللازم. This is the fusion zone. طول طبعا يعني فيها شيء من الإزاحة وعدم الفيرتيكال والفيرتيكال لانه مثلا هو ده بالتالي الفيوجن زون will be here. This is the fusion zone marked by red color and this is the what's the name of this zone? A layer crystallization zone, but it has another name. As we learned before in casting, when the molten metal touches cold metal, it will make very high temperature heat transfer and doing solidification in one direction like this. Of course, it will do very fine one, very fine grain first, then these fine grains will grow up in paste size, but in one direction like this. Why in one direction? Because there is high heat transfer in this direction. But at the middle, transfer will be equal in all directions. Because this one hot, this one hot, this one hot, everywhere hot. Here no. Here is from this direction is hot, and this metal is cold. And as long as that one hot and that one cold, heat transfer will be in one direction, giving you columnar structure. Columnar, you know column? Why columnar structure? Because one direction of heat transfer. But here, if you look to the metal found here and cooling down, all the ambient bars of the metal has the same, almost the same temperature, therefore heat transfer will be in all directions, giving you what's called first fine, then coarse, what's called equiaxial grains. But we have two types of grains. Number one, columnar grain and equiaxial at the middle. Equiaxial grains. Columnar grain, equiaxial grain. Equiaxial grain is that one. Columnar grain here, near the boundary. Fine and coarse. Fine is here and coarse next. Fine is here and then coarse next. What is the name of the zone? Fusion zone. This one is called fusion zone. I will give it here. Fusion zone. Fusion zone is what? Heated up to or higher than fusion zone. Heated up
higher than
melting
point. Don't forget this. Otherwise, why it was melted? Why it was melted? Because temperature there is higher than melting point. So higher than. Okay, that one, the blue color, will never be melted. Because why it will never be melted here? It is lower what? Melting point. But something will happen. What is it? Here. In this range, the crystallization starts at 750 and stops at 1600, melting the metal. But before happening, recrystallization. What is recrystallization? Recrystallization means like this. If you have here in the bare metal very, very small and fine grains, these grains here will be collected together and form one grain. Yani, every 100 grain of that one will form one grain. Coarse grains, due to what? Crystallization. What's the crystallization? Every 100 of fine grain will do one grain. Okay? The rich man doing what? The rich man. Here, there is a rich man. He will do what? He will buy, he will take his father's house and buy all houses near it, about 100 houses, and do it what? One villa, one house, one palace. Like this. This is recrystallization in simple way. Okay? This happened, what happened in recrystallization. Why they are rich? By what? By temperature. But the heat content doesn't reach the melting. The energy doesn't reach the melting. Only the crystallization. Therefore, we call that one not recrystallization zone, we call it heat affected zone. And be affected by the heat. Therefore, we call it heat affected zone. This one in blue color, heat affected zone, HAZ. What is the rest? Base metal or parent metal. Even here is parent metal. Parent metal temperature at where? How high the temperature?
Here temperature.
Below, not room, but below recrystallization. Okay, there is no money to do recrystallization. There is no money enough. Okay, energy is not enough to do recrystallization. It's called parent metal, that one, or base metal, parent metal, or base metal. This figure is found in page 667, figure 9. Figure 9, page 667. And don't forget this temperature distribution is not found in the textbook. Please add it. Okay? Keep it in your memory. And forget about it's given here, interface. With the interface here. This surface here, this surface, separation surface found between the two zones, separation surface is called interface. Don't forget about interface, this line or that line.
What about the joints? So what about the joints? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Joints either by this way or by that way. Or like this. Or like that. Or even by this way. According how to put the two sheets together. If both of them have the same blade, with both blades on the tip, side to side, it's called butt welding. And doing welding here, that one is called butt joint. If I put one over the other, one up, one down, then it's called lap joint. Some textbook saying overlap. That one from its shape, T, joint, corner, joint. These are this one, joint types. And this one is called edge. The weld metal added here is called fillet weld. Here also fillet weld or filleted weld can be like this, or it can be other way, convex or concave. And we are doing welding for very, very essential and important parts, then testing of welding should be there. Testing of the welding quality should be there. Corner is also filleted weld, and that one is line weld, and that one is line weld. All of them are line. And we re-strengthen the joint according to the thickness of the sheet. We strengthen the joint. First of all, we do a joint edge for very thin sheets and melting here only without adding any filler wood or filler wire. If they are thick, then we put them aside. And new welding here is called square butt. That one edge butt. If they are thick, then we do single bevel for one single bevel, then if they are more thick, we do double bevel or single V. Can say double bevel. Bevel means the chamfer of the edge of the blade. We do it before on a machine. special machine doing the bevel, either to one blade or both blades. If it is for both blades, it's called double bevel, or you can say single V. Single V. If they are more thick, then we can do double V, double bevel, like this, lower K, letter K, or we can do double V if they are more and more thick. Also, we can do this shape, which is called J. J. Single J. And so you can see it on page 661. Figure 4, figure 2, figure 3, figure 2 and 3, 61 and 62 pages. Sorry, this one 60 and 61. That one figure 4, page 6 and 60. One. And many other shapes, you can follow them in the textbook. Now, write this title for next lecture. Welding processes.